Hello, my name is Christian Taylor. I'm coming to you from the Right to Dream Football Academy. Welcome to the Right to Dream Robotics Series. For this episode, we're going to look at how to use the large motor. Now, when you get your Ev3 intelligent brick, normally, if you're using the home edition as I have here, you would have to find 6 AA batteries to power it up. But if you have the education edition, it comes with a rechargeable battery that you can just slot in and turn it on. To power it up, you press the middle button over here. You press and hold for about 3 seconds. Then the red light comes on, and it's going to take about 50 to 60 seconds to start up. Once it started up, you see the indicator LED turns from red to green. But if it doesn't turn green, it could be that your battery is not very good. This is a brand new intelligent brick. There's absolutely no program installed on it. So the first option you would see everything being here would be blank. To connect your large motor to your intelligent brick, you need to first get the connecting wires. Normally within a pack, you would find different length of wires, and you can use any of them interchangeably depending on how long or how far away you intend to keep the motor from the intelligent brick. If you look at the intelligent brick, you would find 8 ports in total for connecting motors and sensors. On one side, you would find the ports are labeled with letters, so A, B, C, and D. And on the other side, you find the ports are labeled with numbers, so 1, 2, 3, and 4. You connect output devices such as motors to the letters, and then you connect input devices such as sensors to the numbers. Think about outputs and inputs as actions and senses. So for example, a human being, your eyes, your ears, your nose are your input devices. Those are the things that you use to negotiate your way around your environment. And all of that information goes into your brain for it to be processed. So motors are output devices. So to connect a motor to an intelligent brick, you connect it to any of the letter ports. You can choose any of the ports that you like. Normally, I like to start with the first letter, but that's just my choice. It doesn't mean it can't work any other way. This cable has clips on the end, RJ47 clips, the same kind of clips you find on telephone cables. You slot that in and make sure it clicks. And then the other end goes into any of the letter ports. So I'm working with port A. So the large motor works in 3 modes. The first mode is rotation, the other mode is degrees, and then the third mode is time. Rotation is one of the most commonest modes that most people would use the medium or the large motor in. So it's simple. This is a motor that does circular motion. And you know when there's a circle, so you start at the beginning of the circle. Let's use this to illustrate. So, starting from here, if the motor moves and then it comes back to where it started, that is one rotation. If it moves from a point halfway, that is half a rotation. Or it can move a quarter movement, which is a quarter of a rotation. Degrees is kind of like rotation. In fact, it's the same thing, but you just work with bigger numbers. So for example, one rotation is 360 degrees. So if you're using rotation, you say one, but if you're using degrees, then you say 360. And I believe you already know that 360 degrees makes a full circle. So you might be wondering what's the difference between rotations and degrees, since they pretty much do the same thing. But in my experience with my students, most often than not, we use degrees when we want to make tiny, precise movements. So for example, you want to move the large motor to 3 degrees. It's easy to do 3 degrees than to calculate how many decimal places within a rotation will get you to move 3 degrees. And on the flip side, if you want to do more rotations or more movements, like you want to roll it up like 50 times, you're covering a large distance. It's easy to say 50 rotations than do 50 times 360 degrees and find out how many degrees will give you that and put that in. So you can use both, whichever one you like, but to make your life easy, If you want to do very tiny, precise movements, you choose to use degrees. If you want to make a lot of movements, you use rotations. So it's up to you. So as we move on, eventually you would see how you'll be able to use both degrees and rotations within the same program. All right, so let's talk about time. Well, you know what time is. So you can let your large motor move for a certain duration of time. Certainly there could be an application where you would want to use time. I rarely use it, my students rarely use it because it's not very reliable. Sometimes you want to get a robot to move and stop at a particular place. Now with time, you can achieve that, but it takes a lot of try and error. So you can still use time just for the purpose of knowing how it works, but I can bet you wouldn't be using it a lot as you move on. Be sure to watch the second part of this episode where I'll show you how to program the large motors using rotations, degrees, and time. Thanks for watching and be sure to subscribe to get notified when new episodes are released. Thank you very much.